when I found me somebody. Just as rare as a flower, that you gave me to wear. So I'll look around, and when I find me somebody, laughs like you, I'll know this love that I'm dreaming. And it won't be the old love that I always knew. I'll know this love that I've been dreaming of, and it
Mary Elizabeth Bowser had a photographic memory. She recorded the conversations overheard of the president and his generals and passed them on to Elizabeth Van Loo, who in turn recoded them into letters, encrypted with the war planning, and sent the correspondence on to the Union forces.
In August of 1861, when Jefferson Davis was moving into the Confederate White House, Miss Van Loo gave Miss Mary Elizabeth Bowser as a gift to Jeff Davis and his wife. She becomes a nanny to their children. She has free run of the Confederate White House. She reads dispatches that comes across the desk. She listens in on state's dinners, and she reports it all to the Union Army. She is the highest placed spy in the Civil War, never detected. Jeff Davis always thought that she was just an illiterate, loyal servant. This is a school teacher from Philadelphia again. After the war, she returns to Philadelphia and goes back to teaching school. She is, again, the highest placed spy in the Civil War, and she was an in-place spy. Now, in modern terminology, we'd say that the legal league was shaping the battlefield, being proactive and not reactive. This is a huge story in the intelligence operations during the Civil War. It's a huge story because, again, this organization is proactive, not reactive, a well-organized organization. And their sophistication is really amazing. When you read David Walker's appeal written in 1839, he talks about how this war is going to be fought by the next generation. Sword against sword will be brought against, from north and south will bring sword against sword, Walker says. He says that this war will be fought by our sons. Again, this is 1829. He writes that in the appeal to colored citizens of the world. But he goes another step. He says, not only will our sons fight it, but this is what we need to do for them. We need to give them notes on the state of Virginia so that they can prepare for this war. Notes on the state of Virginia was written by Thomas Jefferson. It reads like a CIA country report. That's a very sophisticated item to be giving them. This is how sophisticated this intelligence network was. They're behaving like you would expect modern-day operatives to behave.
Mary Elizabeth Bowser accepted the invitation and re-enslaved herself into the household of the President of the Confederacy. You just heard Harry Jones relate this Civil War hidden facts. I'm Grayce Gadson with the Griot Session Moment.